Hey everybody, Mark Davis joining you in the moments following our Monday, December 3rd talk show experience. A good two-thirds of the program given to us by the halftime portion of last night's Cowboys-Eagles game. It had nothing to do with the Cowboys, nothing to do with the Eagles, and in fact, nothing to do with football, except insofar as Bob Costas, whom I love. I love him as a sports genius. I love him as a pop culture maven. But Bob, when it comes to Second Amendment issues, leave them to people who appreciate it. Now, this is not my attempt to silence Bob Costas on matters of gun crime. I always like to invite discordant and conflicting views into my life. But this all got started, again, on something that doesn't really involve football as a game, but involves the horrible tragedy of a Kansas City Chiefs linebacker named Jovan Belcher, who in the wee hours of Saturday got into an argument with his girlfriend. He winds up shooting her and then driving to the Kansas City Chiefs practice facility and killing himself in front of the general manager and the Chiefs coach, Romeo Crennel. There was a big debate over whether they should have even played the game on Sunday, but the debate that really sparked heavily was when Bob Costas, in the middle of covering this in halftime of the Cowboys-Eagles, started to riff on this column by a Kansas City writer, Jason Whitlock, who said, "Guns don't make us safer. The existence of guns exacerbate our arguments. The gun somehow magically taunts us to ramp up the significance of all kinds of debates and how many young people are going to be killed because of the volume of the music coming from their cars." It's like, what? What? All this from an inanimate object, and it was just the 145th opportunity in recent memory to examine how voices on the left will demonize an inanimate object. These are people problems. Jovan Belcher was a messed up dude. He was a murderer first, a suicide second. Why did he kill the girlfriend? I don't know. He's not exactly available for comment now, is he? But there may have been a head injury issue, a concussion issue. Everybody in the NFL has head injury issues now. He may have been drinking all the time. It may be painkillers. Maybe stress in that relationship. Hey, here's a great idea. Don't move in with and make babies with people you're not married to. That's a good stress reducer right there. This guy had a very short fuse. I don't know why, and I have the proper amount of empathy and grieving for everyone all around, but the one thing you won't hear me doing is blaming the gun. This is not a gun problem, it's a people problem. If Bob Costas doesn't get it, that's fine, but Bob, I'll tell you what, let's talk about baseball's labor dispute, or maybe what the best sitcoms of the 60s were. I did not need Bob Costas lecturing me on gun issues at halftime of a football game. And in fact, you know what? Let's say if somebody decided to go off on some pro Second Amendment rant, I'd have said, you know what? Why don't you save that for another time in another show as well. So ultimately, now what we're going to have is an enormous excuse festival. We are now going to hear that maybe that everybody in the NFL, of course, has these helmet-to-helmet contact and horse collar tackles. I mean, it used to be just football, an actual contact sport, and we didn't worry about this so much. And of course, we've got a lot of old NFL guys walking around horrible crippled these days, so maybe we should have paid more attention. But with all the attention paid to what made Mr. Belcher snap, and all the attention paid to inanimate object, what is unfortunately very sadly lost is that this man, and I would go so far as to include the girlfriend on this, the unwise move to make a baby with a man she was not married to. Of course, to all you men, don't make babies with women you're not married to. It takes two not to tango, you could say. All kinds of unfortunate decisions made by people led to this tragedy. The mere availability of a gun is irrelevant. The gun is a moral blank slate. A gun in the hand of a policeman, a soldier, a law-abiding citizen is a good thing. A gun in the hand of a criminal, or someone with a short fuse, or someone with no coping skills, or somebody who's drunk, that's a bad thing. The gun is a blank slate. But to the left, you must blame the gun because the alternative is to acknowledge human evil and hold people actually accountable. And that's something they oh so rarely, rarely do. Well, here's something we do, gosh, every day, talk show time, 7 to 10 a.m. Central Time. Mark Davis Show, join us right here on 660 a.m., The Answer.